North Korea's nuclear threat was one of the topics on the agenda when Secretary Pompeo and Defense Secretary Jim Mattis met with their Australian counterparts in California. Satellite images taken of the launching facility in June and then 1 month later in July appear to show dismantling activity. Pompeo had a cautious response.
We've been pressing for there to be inspectors on the ground when that engine test facility is dismantled, consistent with Chairman Kim's commitment. And I'll leave it at that for this morning.
Asked what further steps North Korea needs to take, Pompeo had this reply.
That's easy. They need to completely, fully denuclearize. That's the steps that Chairman Kim committed to and that the world has demanded through UN Security Council resolutions. It's that straightforward.
On Capitol Hill, some lawmakers were also cautiously optimistic.
This is the first sign that there may be some movement by the North Korean regime in the direction of meeting the commitments that were made. It would be more encouraging to me if we saw the return of the remains of Americans killed in action during the Korean War. It would be even more encouraging if there were some detailed plan discussed about how irreversible and verifiable denuclearization might happen, but this is an encouraging first step.
After their summit in June, Trump said Kim had promised him that a major missile engine testing site would be destroyed soon. But their agreement contained no details about when or how North Korea would abandon its nuclear weapons program or shut down its existing nuclear facilities. Cindy Saine, VOA News, the State Department.